It's when if you fall out of love, that's different.
Yeah, it is.
Obviously, you know, we don't really understand the falling out of love part, but it happens.
My relationship, you know, all the hard shit and whatever, I still, of course, love Mickey, even though we didn't have, what, it's been 2 years? I mean, he doesn't, just about 2 years, he doesn't even want to do anything with me in the bedroom, sort of to say, you know? So there's no making love, no nothing like that. And I sure the hell never cheated on him. It's been almost 2 years where I haven't had that type of, you know, the sexual whatever. But so it's like, if he cheated on me,
yeah, I think so.
And it, what the hell? I've never did anything to him. And I've always been decent and stuff. And, oh, man. And still 2 years without anything to do with my him not touching me and whatever. I still never freaking cheated on him.
And I never showed that video. I decided not to put it up.
Yeah, that's right.
When we found the condoms in the car.
Yeah, I have been hurt, man. Wow.
And he was saying it was his friend's.
Mm-hmm. And his friend, of course, oh, he didn't know. You have to show.
I wonder if I still have that video.
Unreal, people.
I also have a video of him screaming really loud at you that I never put up either.
Oh, you have one?
It was just in case type of thing. Like, if you ever did get a divorce and all that, you at least had something. And I wasn't really sure if it would be a good idea to put on YouTube, especially if it ever blew up and he seen it.
Oh, God, I know. Holy shit.
Before we left? Yeah.
I wouldn't be good.
We would probably be dead.
Remember that time where you cut the freaking internet wire?
And TV wire and all that shit. And my gaming remote.
And he told me, he said, yeah, you fucking bitch, you better do what I fucking tell you to.
Yeah.
Yeah, do what I say. Like, he was talking to me like a fucking dog. And I was shaking and crying and everything. And I did exactly what he, you know, what he told me. He goes, go downstairs or whatever. And he's like, yeah, you better do it, you fucking bitch. All of this, the people that, you know, you don't fucking know this.
Yeah.
And then you go on top of all that abuse and whatever, and 2 years, we haven't done anything. We have not had sex in almost 2 years, freaking July, and I never cheated on him, and I'm still with him, so I don't.
Isn't that what happened with my dad, though? And you, too?
Oh, yeah.
Pretty much same thing?
I never met Mickey until 2004. Your dad didn't want any part of me since 2000.
And how many years were you with him after that?
Three years.
And he cheated on you with several women.
So, I mean, come on. What the hell?
Yeah.
What is it? Because I don't go out. I don't go to bars and hang out. I don't cheat. I don't, I'm not mean to
you. That tree's gonna fall.
So, what the hell causes this? Do they want somebody wild to go out and, oh, I just screwed 5 men and then, oh, yeah, that's gonna turn them on? Well, my wife's a whore. Yeah, I'm gonna stay with her. You know, it's like, no, I have a, please move.
Oh, yeah, that bird. But, like, the weirdest thing is, like, if he thought that you, like, started not to look as good or whatever, why did he get so pissed off when you wanted to go to the gym?
Yeah.
And he was, like, really preventing you from going to the gym.
He would not let me go to the gym no matter
so
what.
So, if he wanted you to look better,
he wanted me to stop
wearing makeup.
Why would
he not want you to go?
When he met me wearing makeup, he's like, you don't need no makeup, don't be wearing no makeup, no nothing like that. I wanted to get my hair cut shorter. And, no, he wants my hair kept long and all this crap. And, you know, something's just very weird.
So do you think, like...
And my God, remember when he put me through hell? It was like I'd go,
which time?
Go to the store, I'd go to the chiropractor, and all he'd say is you cheated on me.
Oh.
And, you know, he would come and say, you're sleeping with your chiropractor, and I mean, oh my God.
And you couldn't go to the fair because for some reason he thought that you were going to have sex with Dad in the middle of the fair.
Yeah. And all the other people, like, oh, dear God. And,
like, literally in public where all the rides are and shit.
And I've had a lot of freaking abuse by him.
Both of them.
Ooh, yeah. 17 years with the first one, because you, no matter what I went through, I thought you're supposed to stay married no matter what.
Yeah.
No matter.
Although
what
it does
through.
Say that you can, according to the Christian thing, it says that not to divorce unless adultery.
Right. So they could, you know, crack your skull open and you're half dead, and you know you don't.
I know.
Dead.
I don't really understand.
You know, they could beat you to no end, but you still have to stay married to them.
That's what it says in the Bible.
Jesus is not.
Like, it does make me wonder if the Bible has been changed.
Yeah, that's kind of a little bit scary.
Because there's no way that if God existed and Jesus existed, there's no way that he would say to stay with your spouse who beats you.
Right.
There's no way.
I don't believe that either. But yeah, I still did all that, and then.
But there are also misinterpretations too, like the turn your other cheek thing.
Yeah, well,
who's the one that said, or who's the one that actually did that literally, where they let, like, where they got hit, and then they turned the other cheek so that they could be hit on the other side? That's not what it meant.
No,
but it just means to, like, let it go or whatever. If you can let it go, you let it go.
Yeah.
You don't, like, go out for revenge.
Right. Like, you know, if they hurt you, not physically or whatever, you know.
Yeah.
Forgive them and whatever stuff like that.
But anyway, do you think that all the stuff with Dad and then the stuff with Mickey, with all the screaming and all the fighting and all that shit, do you think that's what started the anxiety thing that happened in January in my chest and shit for like several months?
I don't know, it's like so many traumatic things, like then that druggy guy in the back and...
Yeah, like, could I have a weird form of PTSD?
Yeah.
I mean, you might have that. That could be why you can't sleep.
Yeah, because when I had my therapist for a little while and I really, really needed her or whatever, I did not remember certain things, and when she was talking to me, and when, like, she would always tell me, when you need to talk something that's, you know, that you're actually gonna, it's gonna, you know, be brought up to you somehow,
yeah,
and you're actually gonna remember it, she said, never do that unless you are with somebody that makes you feel safe.
Right.
And so that's why, at least with her, I knew that if I remembered something and I was there, she could talk me through it and everything would be okay, whatever. So that's why I guess certain things I can't remember, like good times or movies or something like that,
yeah,
because it has been surrounded by bad things.
So is that why I'm starting to forget a lot more? Or could that just be something else? What is it that wants me to not leave the house anymore?
Yeah, I think I still say, I mean, since you were young, that you feel that you have to protect me.
Yeah, that's why I don't want to move out.
Yeah, you have to.
Well, I do. Obviously, I want to move out, but it's like,
because
it feels like I have to have enough money so that you can move out as well. Because there's no way that if I'm not there.
That's not the way it should be.
Yeah, but in a way that is how it should be, though, because your parents brought you up and then you abandoned them? That's how you pay them back?
You always call.
But I'm just afraid that if I leave, if I somehow can with a job and stuff, that things might actually get even worse. Because he knows that nobody else is in the house now.
So, yeah, that's what you're worried about. I knew that you were worried about more than just...
Well, considering what he does while I'm there, and he even said that he was afraid of me a little bit, because he, remember when he told you that he didn't, you know, he was afraid that I might ever hit him And shit, remember he told you that back in New York?
Yeah, because he said if you did, you know, of course he'd hit you.
Right. But obviously I wouldn't hit first. Yeah. It'd be the other way around.
Yeah, but then you could because it's... And with me, it's so weird because I'm just... all I want is peace.
And I can guarantee you we will never get it with him. You will never, ever have peace until you leave.
Same thing with...
You might have temporary peace, but you're not going to have peace until you leave. There's no way.
With your dad, I'm like, can I have a hug? And he's like, a huge hug. And he'd leave his arms down. Like,
yeah.
And I'd be hugging him. That's what I got. Why did they change so much?
How exactly did they
leave? Can I have a hug? That's all I said like that. And I was like, wow, you know, I wanted to freaking scalp him or, you know, my Indian. That's all I asked him. That's what I got. That's so strong.
Holy crap, they have a lot of watermelons. Shoot, I didn't even get it on the camera. How did we even get in that conversation?
I don't know.
We do that sometimes, don't we? No idea how it happens, but we did.
No, that was strange.
So, as you guys may know, I usually record videos several days ahead of time. Sometimes it's the day before, but sometimes I actually have several videos ahead of time. So I think I'm going to have to upload this. I mean, you know, schedule it because I still have several videos in line. But probably when we get home, just in case we lose power and stuff for the next couple days.
Oh, could you imagine that? No air conditioning for me. Like that.
Yeah, it's almost 100.
And that was that friggin' blood pressure shit that I've been getting.
Yeah.
And, oh, dear God.
So yeah, I'm gonna have to get this video, and it's probably gonna be a two-part video since the other part is like the part we were just talking about is something completely different from the general stuff. So
we should do that sometimes too, like if you watch a video or something and then we could, like, you know, we both did or whatever, and then we could just say what we thought about it or something
Like that. Well, there is actually one where you can actually record yourself watching that video.
Because
it's called reaction videos. Those channels go so big. It's just you got to worry about copyright and all that.
What's going on up here?
But you can always talk about certain subjects and stuff. Like, what about the monkey in the zoo and stuff?
Oh, no!
We can't talk about that right now.
Oh, no. What's going on? Oh, this is last person. Time.
Yeah, this because,
why don't they...
Yeah, it was the other Sunday.
I gotta get that my hair cut. Look at the... Oh, my gosh. I grow dog ears. And then when they do the dog ears...
Isn't that funny? First time I actually bring the battery thing that you bought me... I don't know if you can see it in the mirror or not. This thing that I got for Christmas. Like,
I don't know what you're trying to do.
This thing, the anchor thing. That I got for Christmas. The first time I actually bring it is when I actually needed it because the camera battery died.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
And when we were talking?
Yeah.
How much?
Just when you stopped at the police guy. So I guess this is gonna be a two-part video and I gotta get it up. That's sexual.
I didn't even think about that, you nasty.
Oh yeah, you guys know Slither. I uploaded that video on my gaming channel. I played it not recording and I named it Surprise Butt Sex. And I got it to second place on the leaderboards. So everybody's seen that, so. Yeah. Unless that was something else and it was eighth place for Surprise Butt Sex. Yeah, eighth place for Surprise Butt Sex.
Terrible.
That's funny though, right?
Yeah. Because that's what I do. When I play it and I'm trying to be doing the worm at the same time, I have to read everybody's nicknames. And I'm freaking laughing, and sometimes I'm like, shit, because my worm, you know, gets eaten, which makes me mad, but I have to read the nicknames, and I absolutely love some of them.
Yeah. For all I know, this may be 3 videos if I record anything from Walmart or after Walmart, because we can finally go to Walmart with the car now, because you've been without.
Oh, no.
Oh, boy.
Where are you going?
They need to get something at Walmart. They need to go to Walmart.
Yeah. Hope it's not for water.
Yeah.
If they need one. No, that's bad.
Fire extinguisher.
Oh.
How come we don't have one?
I thought that
guy was driving on the road.
Well, I hope he was.
No, him. Oh. The guy in the...
I thought you meant the car.
This may be 3 videos. Holy shit. In one day. But, how come we don't have a fire extinguisher?
Yeah, that really makes me mad. Look at the close calls. Thank you, God, because...
Yeah. 3.
Washing
hey, you said
machine,
it comes...
Washing
you,
machines.
You said it came in 3s. So, if it happened 3 times, that means there's no more, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm hoping. But then, remember when I had a weird feeling about the air conditioner? And then we took off the back? And
yeah,
then,
yeah.
You know, my God, it stayed hot
but
for hours.
But technically... Because it didn't shut off or do anything.
Right.
We don't really know, but at the same time we do. I mean, feel the bottom of this camera. Feel the heat.
Wow.
Yeah. It's just a small Handycam camera.
Okay.
Yeah. So why is it so hot?
That's scary.
Just recording for what, 20 minutes?
And that's a battery. That's
that hot?
Plugged into an electricity.
Right. This was before I plugged it in. It's so hot on my hands.
Okay, that's good. It's like cell phones, and all of a sudden they just melt. Oh, no! They don't melt with the batteries.
Does the camera need a built-in fan?
Crap.
On the inside for the processor, or whatever
See,
it is?
You never think about it, what it looks like.
Okay, we've been here for a long time.
Yes.
How do they still have green lights?
Can you believe this? They don't have it right, because as soon as this one does, it'll be, oops, one car, and then it'll go back to red.
Nah, I forgot. I don't remember what I was
going to say. Oh my goodness! We're the ones that sat here for an hour, so it's like, we really want to go.
Well, you could always talk about it. What was your opinion on the gorilla and the zoo and the boy and stuff?
Oh, brother. Number one, the parent did not watch the child.
There were reports that she was on a cell phone. The child repeatedly told her that he wants to go down with the gorillas. She ignored it and stayed on the cell phone, and then he decided to go and play with the gorillas because she didn't say nothing else. So, knowing that information, hey, I was right.
Wow, that ain't funny, Tom.
I was right. They actually did need to go to Walmart.
Holy shit. Calm your asshole down.
Why are they honking they stopped?
Yeah, I know. I thought it was just penis behind me.
Right, that's what I mean. They haunted us, but these people were stopped.
Yeah. They're not going fast here.
There's 2. What do you think happened? And why is it 2 fire trucks? No ambulance, but 2 fire trucks and a cop.
Because sometimes it's weird, if somebody needs an ambulance, the fire trucks will show up and the police before
right.
the ambulance ever does.
Yeah, I guess.
But I don't under, but two fire trucks? Normally it's just one.
She was buying a air conditioner.
Oh, was she? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, I tell you what.
Yeah, I told you Walmart had them.
You cannot just handle.
Just not powerful ones. She got a 5,000 BTU.
Oh.
That's only a one room thing.
Yeah.
Ours is 10,000. It's still like one room and like it goes up to like, what, the hallway?
Yeah, I think so. But that's better than
Walmart time. Oh yeah, that's what I was gonna say. You haven't been with you haven't had cat litter in a while.
Can you imagine? Poor oh, did you tell them what happened to Tasha?
Yeah, they seen the video.
Okay. And then like when she goes to the bathroom, I kept telling Mickey, now Mickey works right next to Winn-Dixie.
Mm-hmm. Well, here we go. Ambulance.
So he used to be able to just, you know, when it's not so busy and close to when Winn-Dixie would close, he would go out and have somebody just run in and get something that we need or whatever. And he said any time except not normally Thursday, Friday, or Saturday. But he would not get it for me. And when he texted me, he was like, oh, it's slow or this is or whatever, but he would just never get it.
He so said no, like, didn't he?
Huh?
Didn't he say no?
Yeah, he was like, for that, he was like, no, I can't do that now, blah, blah, blah. But yeah, I didn't have a car to go get it, even though he's right next door. And so today, he was like, oh, you're going to get cat shit?
And I should have really told him. He really does not like anything to do with the cats.
Yeah,
no,
he used to love
them. Well, he never liked
the screaming
animals.
Scared Mookie and Tasha. Now Mookie don't want no part of him. And Mookie, he was, remember when Mickey loved her so much? And now because Mookie won't go near him anymore, he's like, you're going to get cat shit? And I, like I told Thomas, I should have said, no, I have cat shit at home. I need the kitty litter. You get it? Cat shit.
Yeah.
Home in the... You going to go get cat shit? No, I have the cat shit. It's home in the litter box. That's why I need the litter.
And some days you don't even dare to ask him for water.
Oh, frick no. No, because that one day he's like, all I do is carry stuff. So we have no car. How the hell am I supposed to go and get it done? What, take another taxi? So I can take that out of my doctor fucking money so I can go...
$50.
So it'd be $100 to get here, to Walmart. Because it really, for 3 miles, it was $25. I've never seen, this is the most retarded shit. They used to go friggin' 19 miles for $20.
Hmm.
Now 19 miles, wow.
Why don't they work like a normal taxi, though, where it's charged based on how far you go?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, like New York Taxi, it's like whatever by the minute or whatever.
And as soon as you get in, that's when their thing starts.
Uh-huh.
Not, oh, well, you had to pay for where we came from. What the hell is that? That's not the way it's supposed to be. Because it's like wherever they are, they come and get you, then they press the thing, and how many miles you go,
right.
And then that's how much you owe. But these around here are like, oh, well, you know, you had to pay for wherever we were. What the hell is the hell? What the hell? What the hell? What the hell? That doesn't make any sense, and so that means that they are just, they're all... You know what they are.
So what exactly did they have to do with the gorilla and the
what the hell happened?